Chapter 23. Lunch with Mrs. Knight was pleasant, but Tony felt the subtle undercurrent clouding their external conversation. As they were waiting for their food, Ariel dove right into the reason for their discomfort.
"Before we eat, I'd like to know why you called. Worry spoils the digestion." "No, wait a minute, I'll tell you. You want me to look into those girls' murders. So far, the police are batting zero, so you thought of me. Am I right?"
It was pointless to deny.
"Yes." "You know, I haven't done anything in almost 2 years. I found it was aging me far too quickly."
Tony remembered she had suffered a slight coronary the last time. He instantly felt guilty, but he was still convinced they needed whatever assistance she could give them, or they may never find this man and he would continue his reign of terror. No, he had to try anything he could think of. Not just for any future victims, but also for him and Siobhan. He began telling Ariel the few facts they had put together. He made sure she realized the desperation of the situation. Ariel listened, nodding her head in agreement, an expression of worry on her face.
"Yes,"
she sighed.
"Can we start on Monday? I need the weekend to prepare."
"Fine. Monday's fine. I know this was a hard decision for you. I more than appreciate what you're doing."
"You're welcome, dear boy. Now let's order lunch."
He saw her expression didn't match the light tone of her voice and caught the worried expression on her face as they waited for their entrees. Ariel attempted small talk.
"Aren't you glad we rid ourselves of unpleasant conversation first?"
Attempting to push their worries aside, they tried to enjoy their lunch, but with the unknown ahead, their appetites had vanished. Siobhan and Jared were also having lunch together. She cocked her head, watching Jared's demeanor, and realized something was bothering him. Although they hadn't been partners long, she read him like a book. What was it now? Suddenly it came to her. It's Tony. He wants to ask about us. She wanted to wait and watch him squirm a bit, but patience was never her strong suit.
"Can we talk for a minute? I think we need to clear the air."
He looked so puzzled and surprised that she almost stopped, but she forged on.
"First, I want to preface this with, we both know what happens after I leave work. My personal life is none of your concern, but I'm sure you're curious to know the status of my relationship with Tony."
"Well, I have to wonder. I mean, I don't want you to think I'm butting in, but now that Tony's cleared, what is happening with you two?" "Shit. I didn't mean it like... I mean, it sounded like I was asking if you two were sleeping together. I mean... Siobhan saw the embarrassment on his face.
"Why do you ask?"
"Well, I know you've both been through a roller coaster of emotions in a very short time. Look, what I'm trying to say is, I want you to know if you need someone to talk to, I'm here. I've watched you this past week, and under the circumstances, you're all right, Vaughn, that's all. I consider you not only a partner, but I'm hoping we can become friends." He stopped and waited for her reaction.
"Well, friend, I appreciate your concern. Honestly, I'm a little surprised myself at the way things are turning out."
She realized she did need someone to confide in, and suddenly a feeling of loneliness overwhelmed her. She missed her parents. They died in a car accident so long ago that sometimes she couldn't remember their faces. They weren't here to see her accomplishments, yet in her heart, she believed they watched over her. Siobhan wondered what their reaction would have been if they knew what she was up to at this stage in her life.
"I can't explain this. I care for Tony more than I have any man in a long time. Of course I have my reservations."
"Like what?"
"Probably the same as yours, like how is this happening so fast? I mean, not only is he a white guy, but he's a murder suspect in my first case. I've never behaved this recklessly, ever. I don't know if I'm making the right decision or not. For once, I'm throwing caution to the wind. He makes me feel good. All I know is I need him in my life. I also know I want you as a friend as well as a partner."
He looked relieved. She knew he meant well. It had turned out just fine. They were okay.
"Well?"
Siobhan was waiting for his answer. "Look, we both know I can't tell you what to do with your life. If that's what you want, what can I say? Just know if you ever need me, I'll be no more than a few minutes away."
She reached across the table and took hold of his hand.
You're going to make a great partner. Thank you, Jared.
He glanced down sheepishly. Whatever I can do to help, don't you ever forget that. As they left the diner, Jared tentatively put his arm around her shoulders. You're something else, you know. Siobhan nudged him.
Yeah, now if we could only figure out what.
The small joke lifted her mood, just a little. Bye.